In Ukraine, pro-Russian forces have been closing churches and arresting pastors in areas now under their control. Occupying forces have closed down the three largest evangelical Protestant churches in Melitopol and shut down churches in Mariupol. Russian troops raided Melitopol's Grace Baptist Church while a worship service was underway. That service was being streamed live while the troops moved in. Viewers watched online as they halted the service. Associates of Release International described the raid. They entered the sanctuary while the congregation was singing, registered the names of all present, and detained several ministers. The occupiers closed down the church and gave the pastor just 48 hours to get out of the city. The previous month, occupation forces shut down the city's largest Protestant church, Melitopol Christian Church, which has a 1,000-seat auditorium. They tore down its cross and have turned the building into a cultural, sports, entertainment complex. In a nearby village, Russian Federation soldiers entered another church and broke up the evening service. They told the congregation, "Your feet will not be here after the referendum. We have only one faith, Orthodoxy." In common with dictators down the ages, religion has been used by President Putin as a justification and an excuse for waging war. The confiscation of church buildings and the detention of pastors is reportedly also underway in other Russian-occupied cities, including Mariupol. At one church, armed soldiers, their faces hidden by masks, detained a Baptist pastor and his wife after raiding their home. Neighbours described hearing groans and cries as they were taken away. No word has been given to the family or church members about why or where they were being held. In Crimea and other occupied territories, Russian occupying forces have raided places of worship, closed churches, banned missionary activity, fined people for leading worship meetings, seized religious literature, and forced religious communities to re-register with the state, refusing that re-registration to the vast majority. And now we're seeing churches raided, sealed, and shut down, and the disappearance and detention of pastors in the occupied areas. Ukrainian Christians have been here before. They're being driven back to the underground churches of the Soviet era. Yet the message of history should be clear to Russia. The Christian faith has survived 70 years of Soviet totalitarian rule, and it thrives today in China under similar conditions. Persecution can only strengthen the church.